Welcome to This Ready to Craft. In this video, I will show you how to use ReadyBoard foam board to create Art Nouveau-inspired faux stained glass. To begin, I've attached my template to a piece of foam board using repositionable spray adhesive. You can also use rubber cement for this. I'm going to cut the outer circle first. Clean up any edges as needed. Moving to my interior cuts, I've already put a new blade in my hobby knife. For these small areas, I'm going to elevate my piece of foam board off the table and push the blade through. Work slowly and always be very cautious of your fingers. I'll frequently cut from the back as well, making sure that the paper there has been cut. You could also simplify the design and merge the smaller areas into larger sections. If you feel your knife beginning to drag, change out your blade. On the larger areas, I will alternate between pushing the knife through the board and cutting. Once I finally have everything cut out, I will peel off the template. Be careful not to peel any of the paper facer off the foam board. With my template removed, I'll go back and clean up any edges that aren't quite perfect. I'm using a metallic copper acrylic to paint my foam board. This step isn't necessary, but I think the metallic looks really nice. In total, I used 2 coats of paint. Allow that to dry completely before moving on. I've already cut a piece of contact paper off of my roll. I'm going to peel the backing away from one edge. Now that I have a little contact paper exposed, I'm going to press my foam board into it and use a scrap piece of foam to smooth the adhesive down as I peel the rest of the back off. Make sure the contact paper is adhered really well, especially around the edges. This is what will keep our resin from spilling out and making a giant mess. Once I'm convinced that it's stuck, I'll flip it back over and trim away the bulk of the excess. Mix your resin according to the product's instructions for the next step. I'm going to drip resin into my windows. We're only trying to fill the sections approximately halfway. You want to make sure that you have resin touching all of your edges and coating the contact paper bottom. This can get a little messy, so it's a good idea to keep paper towel around. Swabs are also helpful, but watch out and make sure that none of the cotton fiber ends up in your resin. notice air bubbles in your resin. Using a flashlight will make them easier to see. To remove some of them, you can use a straw and gently puff air into the areas with bubbles. This breaks the surface tension and will allow the bubbles to pop. Some resin tutorials suggest using a lighter to pop bubbles. Do not do this on this project, as foam board is flammable. Allow that to fully cure. For my resin, that meant 72 hours. It's a good idea to cover your project while it sets up, otherwise dust and hair might get into it. Once cured, we can begin coloring. I have a variety of Sharpie markers and some rubbing alcohol. I'll color my sections with the marker. Then, drip alcohol into the areas. This will give us a watercolor effect as the alcohol reacts with the marker ink. You may notice that if there's alcohol in a section that the marker won't color, simply wipe up the alcohol that's there. Allow the alcohol and ink to dry completely. There are a few spots on my foam board where I got marker on or rubbed the paint right off, so I'm going to go back and touch up my paint there. Mix up more resin. I needed about 2/3 of the amount that I used the first time. Drip the resin into the sections again. This time, keep an eye on the level. If you overfill, there's a good chance the resin will spill out. Thank you. allow that to cure completely again. Now that it's cured, it's time to peel off the back. Take your time and go slow. The side that was attached to the contact paper will be matte. The other side should be glossy. Because I want to be able to display my project from both sides, I'm going to use an eye pin to create a hanging point. I've already made a hole, and I'm going to put some white glue into it. And push the eye pin into the foam. Make sure to keep it straight, otherwise you might puncture the sides of your foam board. I will let that glue dry completely before adding a jump ring and some ribbon or string to hang it by. If you try this craft out, we'd love to see it. Our social media links can be found in the description. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If there's a foam board craft that you'd like to see a ready to craft of, let us know in the comments.